off the hook to actually go off and explore what really did excite us and what was progress in our minds. Why Berlin? I can't really remember back that far.
The studio is really cheap.
With no bad vibes there when we were there, other than, you know, they just smelly feet or whatever. I'm learning to lie.
Obviously, Berlin was exciting because the whole reunification thing was happening. You know, there was a lot of change happening in Europe. I wouldn't say we went there for any political reasons. It just seemed like a place to be before it all changed.
So we went and we visited during the summer before we came out, and just really liked the studio and liked the location and got a good feeling off Berlin.
We ate the food, we drank the wine, everybody having a good time, except you. You were talking about the end of the world.
There was this sense that Berlin was where it was. You're not just being dedicated followers of fashion. It's more than just style. I mean, we don't have any style anyway. Swagger, no style.
We always like to work in studios or environments that were inspiring, and we'd visited Hansa on a sort of recce, and anyone who'd ever worked there had said it was inspiring and that they'd got great things out of it, they got great sounds. We went there and a similar thing happened. It is just one of those great rooms for playing music.
I think we've always had a far better understanding of what we don't want to be than what we do want to be. And the finding out what we actually want is the whole process of making the record. So going into this record, we knew that certain things we'd done we didn't want to do again, certain kinds of songs we didn't want to write again. And the whole process in Berlin and in Dublin was finding out exactly where we did want to go.
And halfway through it, when we were making the record, we thought, you know, is this all going wrong? Have we got this terribly wrong? And we just went with it because, you don't have a choice when you're in the middle of a record. You know, you're always going to doubt yourself.
Oh, I can't even say the bloody word. Octoon, baby.
It never officially had another name. There was a brief moment when it might have been called Adam. But that depended on the photography. There might have been a much bigger fifth member on the sleeve.
It's a calm. It's a calm. It's just a way of putting people off from the fact that it's a heavy mother. It's a very... It's probably our most serious record, and yet it's the least serious title. And it just fooled everyone. They all thought we were in... You know, we lightened up, which is totally untrue. We're miserable bastards. You're so cruel.
I like the songs that seem to just arrive.
Desperation is a tender trap.
One is a song like that. So Cruel was a song like that.
You put your lips to her lips.
I enjoy those always because I know they don't take much time.
Her skin is pale like God's only
dust. They had to really branch out and experiment and do things that we hadn't done before. And that's what happened. And everyone had a huge responsibility.
It wasn't really until the last month that everyone felt they had a grip on it.
Very often it's almost the songs that create the finished work rather than your original idea.
The biggest tip that you can get is when you're in the room playing and the music comes.
Once that moment happens in a record, there's a flurry of activity to get it all finished for a deadline that you choose.
Often the lyrics dictate the context and the music.
I don't think the lyrics are worth a shit, to be honest, if you ask me. I think it's all about drums.
In the end, I think I know we made the right decision. We did the right thing. We made the album that we felt we had to make, and the album that we wanted to make. And it was a hard record to make, but the end result is exactly as we wanted it to be.
I have a weakness for belly dancers.